Okay, so hi, I just wanted to tell you about my pretty simple makeup look for today. I am just going to the gym for a little while, so yeah, I don't really have plans today, and I didn't really intend on spending money today, so yeah, I'm just gonna be going to the gym. So I did try out a new lipstick today, and I really am obsessed with this right now. I really am loving all three of the formulas of this lipstick, so yeah, I just did my no makeup makeup look. So I just concealed with the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the color Fair, and then I set my face with the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores Pressed Powder, and I set my under eyes and my actual eye with the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder. Then I went in with the L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara on the top, and then I bronzed up the skin with the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer, and then I went in with the Balm Cosmetics blush in the shade Balm Beach, and then I highlighted with the MAC Mineralize Skin Finish in the shade Lightscapade. And then I went over everything with the Hourglass Theralight powder, and then I just everything with the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. Then I filled in my brows with the, and then I just brushed in my brows with a spoolie and then set them with the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. I know they kind of look like shit right now, but I guess I'll probably fix them up tonight. And then for my lips, I prime with the NYX lip primer, and then I line them with the ColourPop Lippy Pencil in the shade Skimpy, and then I filled them in with the ColourPop Ultra Matte Lip in the shade Aquarius 2. And again, this is one of the Kathleen Lights shades that they just came out with, and I'm really loving this one. I think it looks really good. It's not flaking at all. It's not transferring from my bottom to my top lip. There's no flakes, nothing. So I really do love this one so far. I was really impressed with it. I'm really in a bad mood still, so I'm hoping to just take out some of my frustrations at the gym, honestly. I need to go work out to take my mind off some of things. Some things. I was even fighting with my friend yesterday because, you know, he thinks I'm being a bitch because I'm in such a bad mood lately because of everything that's going on in my house, but whatever. So I'm not really going to be too enthusiastic in these. I'm really, really sorry, but at least these aren't like my regular videos. They're kind of just, you know, a little bit of a glimpse into my life. So, I am going to be recording a haul video on Wednesday, I think. I'm just waiting for the Nicole Guerrero Glow Kit to get here tomorrow. And then I'm going to record a haul because I really can't buy too much makeup at all this month because I really need to budget since I didn't get the money for my tax return because my mom decided to keep it from me. I need to budget more this month, and I'm just listening to see if she's here. I don't think she's here yet. So I do have enough things to record like a haul with. I have stuff from ColourPop, I have stuff from Colored Rain, and I'm gonna get the glow kit, and I have like a couple of items, like one item from Ulta, well, two items, because I'm about to go exchange the Burt's Bees makeup wipes for a different makeup wipe at the drugstore because I tried them last night and they were horrible. They didn't really get anything off and I felt like they kind of left like a flaky residue on my face and my face was like really dry this morning, so I really had to moisturize my face a lot more this morning because I noticed it was like flaky all around my mouth and around my nose. So I'm gonna go exchange them for the simple micellar wipes because I know that I liked the regular simple ones. I didn't love them because I didn't love the texture of the wipe, but they did do the job. They did get my makeup off. This took like so much work to get the makeup off, and I felt like when I was using the wipe, it didn't smell good, first of all. I mean, yes, it was unscented, but I didn't like the scent. Like, it was just like I just didn't like the scent at all. And it had like, it wasn't very wet, and it kind of felt, you know, like it wasn't really getting off anything. So I know I've heard like good things about them, so I thought I was gonna like it, but I guess not. So I'm gonna exchange them for those ones. Those are like Kathleen Lights' favorite like drugstore ones. So I'm just gonna exchange them for those. And yeah, that's pretty much it. But yeah, I have those. And I also have the Lush face wash and a Sephora mask and the L'Oreal Telescopic mascara. So I have like enough stuff to put into one haul, and I'm probably not gonna haul everything else until next month because I really can't. Because my boyfriend's birthday's at the end of this month, and I promised him that I would take him out to an expensive dinner because he did that for my birthday, and I've been promising him to take him to his favorite restaurant for like years now, so I think I'm finally gonna do it this year. And then hopefully in April I'll be able to afford more stuff. But it's not like I can't afford it, but I can't spend it if I'm gonna have to spend money on his birthday dinner at the end of the month. So the only things I really wanted to still pick up is the one palette from Juvia's Place, but the Juvia's Place palettes are so decently priced. They're only $25. So I might pick that up way before I haul anything else, but I'm gonna save that for another haul. But I'm just waiting for the glow kit, and I'm probably gonna record my haul on Wednesday because I don't think I'm doing anything tomorrow either. So yeah, I have to be trapped here today and tomorrow. I might go to Walgreens tomorrow and check out Milani products because I really want to pick up Luminoso finally. I've been wanting that blush like forever. And they're doing a promo right now where it's buy two, get one free. I'm hoping that's going on in the stores too, but if it says Walgreens on my account, my mom's not going to know what I actually bought from there. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So I'm going to go to the gym now and I'm just going to go exchange those wipes. So yeah, that's pretty much it for today. And then I'm probably just gonna come home and watch some more Trailer Park Boys. I'm almost done with season 7 already, so I only have 3 more seasons and then I'll be done with it completely. And then the next season of it starts on Netflix in like a few weeks. So I'm probably gonna be done with it within like 2 weeks. And then I'm probably just gonna start watching New Girl, and then because I'm finally gonna start watching the season that I haven't seen. I was gonna stop watching Trailer Park Boys and just move on to New Girl, but and then go back to it and finish it. But I'm probably going to finish up season 7 at least, and then I'll see what I want to do after that. But I might watch a movie tonight too, if I'm not watching a movie with my mom. So yeah, that's it. Let me stop rambling. So bye. Okay, so hi. So I just wanted to tell you about my makeup look for today. I just got home from seeing my best friend because I actually wasn't sure if I was going to be seeing her before she went to California because she's going back to Connecticut tomorrow because that's where she lives, but her mom lives in New York still, and she comes to stay with her every like other week or something. So I actually wasn't even sure I was going to be seeing her this weekend because she wasn't even going to be here. Today she was supposed to leave to go back home today. She was only supposed to be here Saturday and Sunday, but she ended up staying today. And then I said to her after pretty much when I was at the gym, because I showed you guys what my makeup look was this afternoon, and I thought I was just going to be going to the gym today and then just going to Ulta and then just going home. But she ended up saying, yeah, come over, because I said, why don't I just come over since you're not sure if you're leaving today or not. So ended up seeing her, and I wore my Frozen shirt. So I came home and threw on my clothes and took a shower after I came home from the gym. And now I finally wore this shirt again, so now I don't have to worry about wearing it again this winter. There's only 3 more weeks of winter left, so yeah, and I still have like a shit ton of outfits to wear, so I'm trying to wear as many as I can before the season is over. So yeah, but I just wanted to wear this one today. Because then she goes to California in a few days, but she's only going to be there for 3 days. She's probably going to end up being there like longer than she is supposed to be, but whatever. So anyway, I'm really, really tired. I haven't been getting much sleep lately. So I primed my face with the Smashbox Harbor Water and the CeeLo One Step Corrector. Then I went in with the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Glow Classic Ivory Foundation, and then I concealed with the Maybelline Pro Camouflage Concealer. I forget what the actual name is, but you know what I mean, that squeezy tube one in the shade Fair. And then I started everything with the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores Pressed Powder. I swear, I love how this powder makes my skin look. I actually think I love it over the MAC Miller Skin Finish Natural. I think it's my favorite powder next to the Giorgio Armani because literally those two look like you're not wearing any powder. Your skin just looks flawless when you put it on. It just literally looks airbrushed. Like, and that's literally what the IT Cosmetics powder is supposed to do. Sorry, I'm so tired. Then I primed my eyes with the MAC Prep and Prime 24-Hour Base, and then went over that with the same IT Cosmetics powder. And then I went in with a couple of the ColourPop pressed eyeshadows today just because I really wanted to use them. I kind of just wanted to do a little bit of a matte brown crease rather than wearing a silver crease this time, and I really like how it turned out. So I used the shade Firefly on my crease, of course, as my transition shade. Then I darkened up the crease more with. Oh, so sorry, I'm so tired. With Wake Up Call. And then for the to deepen it up and to darken it up more, I used the shade Filter from the Lime Crime Venus 2 palette. But you probably won't really be able to see it because I feel like the lid shade transferred to the crease, but it looks fine. So for the lid, I went in with the Kat Von D Metal Matte palette and I used the shade Ignite for that lid shade, and I really love how it turned out. And then for the outer corners, I went in with the shade Cloud 9 from the ColourPop shadows, and I really like how it looks on the outer corners. It's really pretty. And then for the brow bone, I used the shades Hear Me Out and Locked and Loaded from the ColourPop single shadows as well. So I pretty much used the ColourPop shadows and just one Kat Von D shadow on the lid, and I really like how it turned out. I did use this shade the last time, and one shade from the Lime Crime palette, but I did use this shade. Oh my God, the last time I wore this shirt, and I really think that this shade is like perfect for this shirt. And then I lined my eyes with the Kat Von D with the CLSAL Day Eyeliner in the shade Black. It did get a little bit screwed up because I tried to reline it again, but I'm just taking it off anyway, so whatever. And then I went in with the Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara on the top. Then I concealed under my eyes with the Maybelline Concealer, and then I set that with the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder, and then I line my waterline with the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide On Sign On Pencil in the shade 0. I'm telling you, it's like my new favorite black eyeliner. I love it so much. And then I went in with the MAC Simply Giga Black Lash on the bottom lashes, and then I highlighted the inner corners with Makeup Geek's Filled Shadow in the shade High Wire. Because I didn't put it in my crease this time, so I wanted to highlight it. My honor. Wanted to highlight my outer corners with it. Can you speak English, Caitlin? Then I contoured my skin with the Marc Jacobs Instamark Dreamer Filter just because I really wanted to use it and I haven't used it to contour in a little while, so I just used that. And then for the blush, I went in with the Urban Decay 24-Hour Afterglow Blush in the shade Indecent. I know I usually match my blush to my lip color, but that would have went with this color would have went with Fetish more, and I just wore Fetish like a couple of days ago, so I decided to wear Indecent today instead. And then for the highlight, I did originally go in with the Urban Decay Afterglow 8-Hour Highlighter in the shade Sin, and then I topped it off with the Anastasia Moonchild Glow Kit, and I used the shade Blue Ice. I should have just mixed Blue Ice and Star together, but for some reason I didn't. And basically, it's just blue ice on my cheeks, and I just really love how it looks anyway. I've just really been loving the Anastasia Glow Kits lately, and I'm getting the Nicole Guerrero Glow Kit tomorrow, so I'm finally going to be able to start using that. And then I went over everything with the Hourglass Ethereal Light Powder, and then I set everything with the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. Then I filled in my brows with the Anastasia Brow Definer in Caramel, and then set that with the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. And then for my lips, I primed them with the NYX Lip Primer. Then I lined them with the ColourPop Lippy Pencil in the shade Lumiere. And then I filled them in with the Too Faced Melt in Matte Liquid Lipstick in the shade Queen B. I swear, I love these lipsticks so much. They dry so quickly, and they last so long, and they are so comfortable. Like, this is like my perfect formula besides the Lime Crime. Like, I love the Lime Crime, but these dry like even faster and they stay on your lips so well. Like, probably the Lime Crime ones are a little bit more longer lasting and the pigment lasts longer, but these are like a close, like, tied with ColourPop. Like, they are so good. Like, I love the Makeup Monsters ones so much too, but this one, in Queen Bee especially, this one is so amazing. Like, I swear, when I'm reapplying it, I don't even have to go like this to wait for it to dry. Like, literally, when I put my lips back together, there's like. And your lips don't even stick together. Like, there's no transfer, nothing. Like, it's so good. It's so good. I just really wanted to wear this one tonight. So, yeah, that is pretty much it. So, bye. I'm really glad I got to see her, though, but we'll see how tomorrow goes. Yeah, so bye. Okay, so hi, so I just wanted to tell you about my makeup look for today. I literally just put on makeup to record a haul video because I ended up not being able to go out today because it just got too late and I didn't have any plans today and I didn't really want to spend any money. So I just ended up staying home and I decided to record a haul video. So I just primed my face with the Smashbox Primer Water and the Laura Mercier Foundation Primer, and then I went in just with the Urban Decay One and Done Complete Complexion Perfector in the color Light, and then I just concealed with the Maybelline Fit Me with the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer in the color Fair, and then I set my face with the Cosmetics Bye-Bye Pores Pressed Powder. Then I primed my eyes with the MAC. Well, actually, I didn't because it like looked so dry for some reason that I just ended up putting on eyeshadow. Then I just went in with the ColourPop shadows today and I used the shade Hear Me Out all over my eyes. And then I went in with Firefly as my transition shade. Then I darkened it up more with the shade, I believe, what is it called? I never remember the eyeshadows. This one is called Wake Up Call, so I used that on the crease. Then I darkened it up more with Note to Self. And then I used a little bit more of Note to Self to define it. And then I went in with Bel Air as well. And I just mixed those two together because I accidentally used Bel Air a little bit more. Oh, actually, Note to Self over Wake Up Call accidentally because I was going to use Note to Self in my crease to define it more. But I ended up using it there too. But I really like how it turned out. So, and then for the lid, I went in with the shade that I haven't used yet on my lid, and that one is called Come and Get It, which is the shade right here. It's so beautiful. It's such a beautiful, like, rose gold shade. I love it so much. And then for my brow bone, I went in again with Hear Me Out and Locked and Loaded. Then for my mascara, I went in with the L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara on the top and bottom, and then I just lined my waterline with the ColourPop Gel Liner in the shade Honeydew, and then I concealed under my eyes with the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer, and then I set that with the Laura Mercier Thicker Blending Powder, and then I went in with the shades Take It Slow and Let Me Explain on my inner corners from ColourPop. So I just wanted to use all of these today because I just recorded a haul, finally sharing these. And then for my face, I bronze up the skin with the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. If you could talk today, that'd be great. Then I went in with the Urban Decay Afterglow 8-Hour Blush in the shade Video. And then that Blingin' Poppin' Highlight. Do you see that Poppin' Highlight? That is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit from Nicole Guerriero, and this is what it looks like. It's so pretty. It's just so pretty. I can't stop staring at the packaging. And I use the shades Kitty Cat and Glow Getter. They are so gorgeous. I really wanted to use Kitty Cat because it looked very pink, but when you actually put it on your face, it's very like wearable. It's not that pink. It's more of like a straight up like white shade, which is so beautiful. And I just mixed literally a hint of Glow Getter with it, and it's just so gorgeous. It's so gorgeous. Then I went over everything with the Hourglass Ethereal Light Powder. Then I set everything with the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. Sorry, I just burped. I don't know why I set it with that, because I thought I was going to be going somewhere, but then I ended up not going anywhere. So, and sorry about my lip. I don't know why it's bleeding like that. It's really annoying me. And then for the lips, I just brushed through my brows with a spoolie and set them with the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. Obviously, I was too lazy to actually fill them in. I primed my lips with the NYX Lip Primer, then I lined them with the ColourPop Lippy Pencil in the shade Skimpy, and then I filled them in with the ColourPop Ultra Satin Lip in the shade Aquarius, and then I topped them off with the Ultra Glossy Lip from ColourPop in the shade Aquarius. So yeah, that is it. Goodbye. I am done talking, and I need to eat, so bye. Okay, so hi, so I just wanted to tell you about my makeup look for today. I actually just got back from hanging out with my boyfriend today. I went over his house around like 5:30 and I actually didn't get home till like 10:45. We went to Micro Center for him to get something for his computer. We got into the mall. We went to out to dinner, to a diner to get some burgers, and we also went to Stop and Shop so we can get some food. Like snacks and stuff. So yeah, I just got home. I'm hanging out with him. We're supposed to go get ramen at like our favorite ramen place on the island, but Just like listening for a second. But we decided that we didn't want to drive that far. It's pretty far away from where we live. It's like 45 minutes away from his house, and there was like heavy traffic when I was getting to him, and also there would have been a lot of traffic like going there, so we just decided not to. So I decided to wear my BCBG plaid dress today just because it's comfortable, but it's also really cute. So just decided to wear it today before the season is over. So I prime my face with the Smashbox Primer Water and the Laura Mercier Foundation Primer. Then I went in with the L'Oreal True Match Lumi Foundation in the color Porcelain, just because I wanted, well, Classic Ivory, just because I wanted something that was like luminous but still like not too full coverage, but it still like covers really beautifully. So I love this foundation. And then I went in with the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in the color NW15. And then I set my face with the MAC Prep and Prime Radiant Rose. And then I set my face with the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores Pressed Powder. Sorry, I'm just like logging into something. Give me 1 second. Then I primed my eyes with the Smashbox 24 Hour Primer and then went over that with the same MAC powder. I find that if I use the MAC one after my skin has been dry for like a couple of days, like if my skin is like a little bit drier and I don't do a mask, I notice that the MAC one kind of flakes a little bit on my eyes. I just feel like my eyes are getting very dry lately and I don't know why. If you guys use like a good eye cream or something, let me know. But usually I just use my moisturizer over my eyes. So I'm just looking at something really quick. Yeah, I'm just looking at this thread that I posted in this forum. So anyway, and then I went in with all ColourPop shadows today. I used a bunch of the pressed eyeshadows because I just really wanted to use them again today, and I feel like I'm going to concentrate more on using those again this month because I feel like I still want to get more use out of them. And it's very hard to use eyeshadows consistently sometimes. I feel like it's like easier for me to use lipstick sometimes. It's just a little bit annoying. So I did use all ColourPop shadows today. So I used Firefly, then I darkened it up with Note to Self, then I used Criss Cross and Popular Demand on the crease, and then for the inner corners I went in with Cloud 9, and then for the lid I went in with one of the Super Shock shadows in the shade Porter from Kathleen Lights from the Where the Night Is collection, and then for the And then I topped it off with one of the Kat Von D Metal Crush shadows, and I used the shade Raw Power. And then for the brow bone, I mixed together Locked and Loaded and Hear Me Out from ColourPop. And then I lined my eyes with the Stila Sail Day Eyeliner in the shade Black. And then I went in with the Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara on the top. Then I concealed under my eyes with the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer, and then I set that with the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder. And then for the waterline, I went in with the ColourPop gel liner in the shade Besso. I just wanted to make it like a ColourPop day. And then I went in with the MAC Centiliqued Black Lash. And then I highlighted the inner corners with, I believe, Just in Time and Save It for Later. I'm pretty sure those were the two shades that I used. I mixed those two gold shades together. Pretty sure those were the two shades from ColourPop, the two shimmery shades. Let's just check really quickly from my haul video. I can just check the description box. And then I contoured my face with the Marc Jacobs Instamark Dreamer Filter. Yeah, Just in Time and Save It for Later. So I used those two. And that was it for the eyes. I really like how it turned out. I really do think that these are becoming like one of my favorite eyeshadow formulas of all time. They are really, really good, and I highly recommend them. They're just as good as Makeup Geek. I love them. And then I went in with the Becca Mineral Blush in the shade Wild Honey. I was trying to see if I was going to use something different, but I do want to try and hit pan on this blush, so I have to use it a lot more often than I actually do. And then I highlighted with the Nicole Guerrero Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit. Obviously, I had to use it again today. And I used the shades Daydream and Glow Getter together. Oh my god, it's so pretty. Look at that. Isn't it gorgeous? I'm obsessed with this kit. I can't wait to talk about it in my March favorites video. And then I went over everything with the hourglass ethereal light powder. Then I started thinking the Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray. Then I filled in my brows with the Anastasia Brow Definer in Caramel, and then set that with the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. And then for my lips, I primed them with the NYX Lip Primer. Then I lined them with the Urban Decay Glide On Slide On 24-Hour Pencil in the shade Liar. And then I filled them in with the ColourPop Ultra Matte Lip in the shade Tool. I do believe that this lip is getting a little bit dried out, and I feel like it might be time to declutter it soon. But I just love this color so much, and I don't want to get rid of it yet. I've only had it for like over a year, so I just feel like they only last about a year. But they're such good lipsticks because they're only $5. So that's it. I'm gonna go because I am super tired. I basically was like got woken up by chainsaws again, cutting down branches outside at like 8:30 in the morning, and then they didn't stop until 1 p.m. So I did not fall back asleep. So I am so ready to go to bed like really soon. I'm gonna try and go to bed early tonight. So yeah, that is it. Goodbye. Okay, so hi. So I just wanted to tell you about my makeup look for today. I actually just got back from hanging out with somebody new today. I actually went to go hang out with my boyfriend's best friend's girlfriend. He actually didn't know we were hanging out, and Josh didn't know we were hanging out. Well, I told him that we were gonna meet up with each other to discuss my boyfriend and her boyfriend's birthdays, because this is like the first year he's like dating somebody steady, and I've never been able to plan a birthday like with one of their girlfriends before. Now I finally can. With one of his girlfriends, I mean. So we were like, she Facebook messaged me like a couple of days ago, and I was like, you know what? If you want to meet up and talk about it, we can. So I've just been really into like darker looks lately. You know, I'm kind of in that phase where I don't really feel like doing color right now. And I'm just obsessed with my ColourPop shadows that I basically said to myself, I just want to use them all week. So I decided to use all ColourPop shadows today. And I kind of wanted to go with a like kind of neutral look but cool tone, and pair with like a brown lip, because I'm gonna try and wear more brown lips this month until April, because you know they're gonna go out of season soon, and it's supposed to be like a snowstorm tomorrow, but it's only supposed to last until like 12 p.m. So I think I'll still be able to see my boyfriend tomorrow. And then I usually go over his house on Saturdays, so hopefully I'll still go out tomorrow. If not, definitely Saturday, but tomorrow I might not be going anywhere. I'm not sure yet. But I might have him pick me up if the snow hasn't cleared off my driveway yet. But anyway, so yeah, we went to go get manicure pedicures together. You guys probably noticed my nails. I got them St. Patrick's themed. I know that's like so cheesy because I didn't get Valentine's Day nails the last time I got a manicure, because I didn't get a manicure till after Valentine's Day. And so this is what I got on my nails, and I really love it. This is like a new brand of nail polish at the nail salon that we went to, because we went to the Broadway Mall one. And then I also wore my new Disney Jungle Book shirt from Hot Topic, because I haven't worn this one yet. And I just decided to wear it because it's super comfortable. And yeah, it's really cute. And I just decided to wear all black today because I wore it with leggings, just because I felt like wearing all black. And I wore my Lady and the Tramp shirt last week, so I wore the Jungle Book shirt today. I'm not sure if I'm going to be recording a video tonight. I kind of feel really tired now. I was thinking about recording my Disney clothing collection, but at the same time, I still have a ton of videos to post that I really haven't been recording too many videos this week. Yeah, so I'm not really sure if I'm actually going to post that or not at some point. I already have a what's in my closet for my BB clothing collection, but I really want to shoot my Disney clothing collection, so because I have a lot of new clothes from I'm like brain farting really badly from Hot Topic that I haven't shared yet, but I'd rather share those in like a haul video, because I got this shirt, I got the Lady and the Tramp shirt, and I got an Aristocats shirt, and I also have a new dress, like a Disney Villains one. So I'm not sure like when I'm gonna be able to post a haul, but maybe soon. I don't know. I was thinking about recording it tonight, but I'm already wearing the Jungle Book shirt and I would wanna show that to you guys in the haul. So let me stop rambling. So I prime my face and I'm like brain farting way too much that I think I just need to take my makeup off because I'm like tired now. I have been out since 5 because I purposely left early. And oh yeah, it was my mom's birthday today, but I decided to not even be there because there's too much shit going on. So I just texted her happy birthday and that's about it. So I prime my face with the Smashbox Permanent Water and the Stila One Step Corrector. Then I went in with the L'Oreal Infallible Foundation in the color 110 Ivory. And then I concealed with the Kat Von D Lock It Concealer in the color L5 Neutral. I'm kind of not feeling how it looks under my eyes, right now. But at least it doesn't like settle into fine lines. Like it kind of settled a little bit, but it really doesn't crease all that much. So I really don't have any problems with it. I love it. And then I went over everything with the, or set everything. Sorry, with the Cosmetics Bye-Bye Pores Pressed Powder. I kind of like stayed out late on purpose. Like, well, stayed out as late as I could on purpose. I went to CVS to try and pick up my prescription, but now I have to call my insurance company and deal with that. My health insurance, such a pain in the ass. And then I went to get gas, and then I like was seeing when she could meet me, and then she said 6, so I was like, okay. So I got there at 6, and she didn't get there till like 6:20, but whatever. And then I got home around like 9. So, yeah, then I primed my eyes with the Smashbox 24-Hour Primer and then went over that with the same IT Cosmetics powder. And then I went in, like I said, with all ColourPop shadows today. I probably could have recreated this look all with Makeup Geek shadows, but I've just been too obsessed with my ColourPop ones that I just really wanted to use them again. So I just went in with Firefly First. Then I used Wake Up Call, and then I used Bel Air to darken it up more. And then for the outer corners, again, I went in with Cloud 9 because that's like really the only brown shade that I have from them. And then I went in with High Strung on my lid. And then for the brow bone, I used Locked and Loaded and Hear Me Out. And then oh my God, I really can't talk. Like, I'm so tired. And then for the liner, I went in with the Stila Sail Day Eyeliner in the shade Black. And then I went in with the Maybelline Lash Sensation Mascara on the top. Then I concealed under my eyes with the Kat Von D Lock It Concealer. And then I set that with the Laura Mercier Sacred Brightening Powder. And I also used the MAC Prep and Prime Radiant Rose all over my face with the concealer. And then for liner, I really cannot stop using this liner on my waterline. It's the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide On Slide On Pencil in the shade 0. I love it so much. And then I highlighted with the shade, I believe, Let Me Explain. Yeah, Let Me Explain from ColourPop. And then I just popped a little bit of Kat Von D's Thunderstruck on the inner corners, too. So that's what I used for my eyes. And then I went in with the MAC Extended Light Kick Black Lash on the bottom lashes. And then I contoured the skin with the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette. And I used the shade Shadow Play. And then I used the lightest shade in the palette to bake it. And then for the blush, I just went in with the Makeup Geek blush in the shade Infatuation, just because I feel like I never have any neutral blushes to use, so I always end up using the same ones. And then for the highlight, obviously I used the Anastasia Glow Kit by Nicole Guerrero again, just because I really want to test it out and test out all of the shades. Look at this. Isn't that, it's beautiful. I haven't found one shade I don't like. I'm literally obsessed with it. So I used the shades Forever Young and 143 today, and I mixed them together. So pretty. And then I went over everything with the Hourglass Ethereal Light Powder. Then I started doing the Urban Decay All-Nighter Setting Spray. Then I filled in my brows with the Anastasia Brow Definer in Caramel, and then set that with the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. And then for my lips, I primed them with the NYX Lip Primer. Then I lined them with the ColourPop Lippy Pencil in the shade Grunge. And then I filled them in with the Urban Decay Vice liquid lipstick in the shade 1993, just because I felt like wearing it again today. I can't believe I've already worn this one 3 times. Like, that doesn't really happen with me and lipsticks very often. It takes me like forever to wear a lipstick, but I really wanted to wear this one again. And I really do love this one. It stays put, it looks beautiful. The only thing is that it does feel a little bit drying, but and it just kind of stick together, but it doesn't go anywhere. Like, this is so much better than the Galactic matte lip paints. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't think I'm gonna record a video. I think I just want to watch some Trailer Park Boys. So yeah, I will record that as soon as I can. I probably will wear a Disney shirt very soon. So yeah, that's it. Bye. Okay, so hi, so I just wanted to tell you about my makeup look for today. I did just go over my boyfriend's house and we just ordered food and watched a movie. We ordered Chili's and then we watched Secret Life of Pets because I finally got him to watch it, and I rented it for him because he actually has been renting a lot of movies for me lately. Basically, every time I go over his house, he's always renting them. So I was like, you know what? I'll rent it for you this time because he wanted to watch Alien because but I'm like, no, I've been wanting you to watch this movie for forever. So we're gonna watch Secret Life of Pets. I didn't know we were staying in, so honestly, I wouldn't have put on this much makeup if I knew that we were just staying in and we weren't doing anything. I probably would have like not even put makeup on, to be honest, because I've been trying to not wear makeup to his house. But since I didn't know, I always have to be prepared of going out with him. But I really had no idea we weren't going anywhere. So anyway, I did just film a review video, so there are gonna be like a bunch of swatches on my hand. But I did wear my Hello Kitty shirt today, just to wear something really comfortable. So I primed my face with the Urban Decay Prep Priming Spray, which is actually right in front of me. Of course, I just sprayed it everywhere, so I'm kind of like sneezing. I did do a full review and like some swatching on most of Urban Decay's fall and winter line. I feel like that was like a video that I've had in mind for a pretty long time. So yeah, I used that and then I went in with the regular Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer over it. And then I went in with the Urban Decay. Ooh, Jesus. Why do I keep on dropping everything tonight? I feel like BBC is like leaking a lot of stuff. Oh, okay, never mind. This is something I don't really need to watch. Anyway, so I went in with the Urban Decay One and Done Hybrid Complexion Perfector in the shade Light. And then I concealed with the Urban Decay Naked Skin Complete Coverage Weightless Concealer in the color Fair Neutral. And the MAC Prep and Prime Radiant Rose. And then I set my face with the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores Pressed Powder. Sorry, we had Chili's tonight, so I have like a lot of gas. Then I primed my eyes with the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer and then Smashbox Photo Finish 24-Hour Primer, and then went over that with the same IT Cosmetics powder. And then I went in with the Urban Decay Naked Ultimate Basics palette today and the Urban Decay After Dark palette. So, because I wanted to use both of these to review a lot of Urban Decay products. So, I used Nudie in the Crease, then I darkened up the crease more with Commando, and then I used Tempted to darken it up more. And then for the outer corners, I used Magnet, which I've never actually used this shade. It's more of a gray tone shade, but it kind of got very blended into like a brown. I don't know why. And then for the lid shade, I used one of the shades from the After Dark palette, and I used the shade Supersonic. So pretty. This is actually the first time I've actually used this shade on my lid, and it was so pretty. And then for the brow bone, I used Blow from the Naked palette. The Ultimate Basics palette. So that's what I used from that. And then I lined my eyes with the Stila All Day Eyeliner in the shade Black. And then I went in with the IT Cosmetics Superhero Mascara on the top. And then I concealed under my eyes with the Urban Decay Concealer. And then I set that with the Laura Mercier Stick Brightening Powder. I feel like I'm so out of breath right now because I feel like I was talking for so long. Then I lined my waterline with the ColourPop Gel Liner in the shade Call Me. And then I went in with the Urban Decay After Dark palette for my inner corners, and I used the shade Alter. And then I went in with the MAC Cinnabigica Black Lash on the bottom lashes. Then I contoured with the MAC Sculpt Contour and Sculpt Yourself palette, and I used the shade Sculpt. And then I used the Emphasize powder to clean it up and bake it a little bit. And then for the cheeks, I went in with the Urban Decay Afterglow 8-Hour Blush in the shade Kinky. And then for the highlights, I mixed two highlights together. I used the Urban Decay Afterglow 8-Hour Highlighter in the shade Sin, And then I went in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Nicole Guerrero Glow Kit in the shade Forever Young. So I really like how those looked together. And then I went over everything with the Hourglass Ethereal Light Powder. Then I started doing the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. Then I filled in my brows with the Anastasia Brow Definer in Caramel and then set that with the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. Then I primed my lips with the NYX Lip Primer. Then I lined them with the MAC Lip Pencil in the shade Subculture. And then I filled them in with the Colored Rain Matte Lip Paint in the shade Marshmallow because I just really wanted to wear it today because, yeah, I wore the Hello Kitty shirt. And it, again, if I knew that we weren't going out, I wouldn't have worn all of this, but at least I wore it to film a video, so it's not like completely wasted. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So bye. Okay, so hi. So I just wanted to tell you about my makeup look for today. First off, I just want to say I really like how my eyes turned out today. I think they actually turned out the way I wanted to them to this time. I actually didn't wear any makeup yesterday. I just wore mascara and a lip because I thought I was going to be going to see my boyfriend and I thought I was just going to be going over his house and we were just going to order like pizza or something and then watch a movie. But as soon as I turned on my car last yesterday to go to his house, my dashboard flashed saying that I had a flat tire. So it hasn't really been like the best week of my life. But today has been a little bit better. My mom did go take in my car this morning to get it fixed, but then again it said that it had low tire pressure again, and I was like, what the fuck is going on? I'm like, why is it doing it again? So I had to go to the tire place with my friends today because I drove my friends in the car for us to go where we wanted to go because we were going to my town's St. Patrick's Day parade today. And yes, it is one of the coldest days of the year, and we actually only ended up staying there for like less than 20 minutes because we all got cold. And we were all too worried about getting my car fixed. Well, I was too worried about getting my car fixed. So I was like, yeah, I'm just gonna go get it fixed. So it like basically took us an hour to actually park for the parade because we all met at 2 o'clock and then we were in the mall for like a little bit, but we didn't go into any stores because we knew we wanted to get to the parade. So I drove everybody around to the parade and then when we got there, or like midway into getting there, my dashboard flashes again saying that I have low tire pressure, and I was like, what the fuck? So we had to go back again and fix it. So right after we left the parade. So we did that, and then I was like, well, at least it got fixed because, and then my mom came to meet us there because she had just gotten done with work or something. So she just wanted to make sure it got fixed. And then my eyebrows are like on another level today, but I really don't care. And then after that, we went to Target because Becca wanted to pick up like a bunch of things, and Phil wanted to go see like video games and stuff. Because this is the first time I've seen Phil in like months, so we finally got to hang out again because we were trying to take Phil out for his birthday, but we didn't really do anything too exciting because, none of us really had that much money. So we went to Target and then we all ate and we went to Moe's. So that was like, and then I got home at 6 o'clock. So I was only out for like 4 hours, but I did wear my Maleficent shirt today for the second time, so I don't have to worry about wearing it again. And now I basically have worn all my Disney shirts except for the Aristocats one and the Beauty and the Beast one, but I'm saving the Beauty and the Beast one for the movie, which comes out next week. And the Aristocats one I was planning on wearing to Happy Hour on Wednesday. So, yeah, so anyway, that was pretty much it. So I did get up pretty early this morning at like 10:30, so I am pretty tired. I was supposed to go pick up Cassie to go to the parade with us, but she never got back to me about it, and I had texted her basically when we had left the parade, and I was like, yeah, there's no way that she's making it here because she told me that she was like waiting for her mom to get back home to watch the babies, and I'm like, well, my fr I have to go get my tire fixed, so I couldn't wait. So, and then I texted her again around like 6 when I was leaving the mall because I then dropped off Becca and Phil and his girlfriend back at the mall so then they could go home because Phil told me he didn't really want to do anything after 6 o'clock. So I was like, okay, whatever. And we were all pretty tired, so I was like, yeah, that's fine. So, yeah, I took them back home, and that was really it. I took them back there, and that was really it. And then I texted her, but then she said that she had to go food shopping with Danny and Cassie and her kids. So I was like, yeah, I'm not seeing her again. But she texted me last night at 11:45 at night asking me to come over when I texted her like at 6 p.m. because my boyfriend told me to stay home because he didn't want me driving on the spare tire because that's just like a temporary tire. He wanted me to go home, so I ended up not seeing him, so that's why I didn't. And plus, I wasn't planning on wearing makeup anyway. Yesterday, I've been kind of giving myself a break from makeup, like every like few days. And she didn't text me back until like 11:45 asking me if I was doing anything, and I was like, I'm home, like I'm not going out now. And then she offered me $30 for me to pick her up and get beer for her at 7-Eleven. Obviously, she's of age. I mean, she's like my age, but yeah, I was just a little bit annoyed. So anyway, I primed my face with the Smashbox Primer Water and the Stila One Step Corrector. Then I went in with the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Glow Foundation in the color Ivory. It looks so good today, and I did this like super quick today, but I feel like it looks very skin-like today, so I was really loving how it looked today. And then, of course, I concealed with my Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer in the color Fair Neutral, just so I don't have to worry about it settling into fine lines or anything. And then I set my face with the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores Pressed Powder. I'm kind of obsessed with this combo because I feel like with the IT Cosmetics, it kind of makes your skin look really airbrushed. And then this like foundation is just like so flawless. It's so good. Then I primed my eyes with the Smashbox 24-Hour Primer and then went over that with the same IT Cosmetics powder. And then I didn't use a transition shade today. I just went in straight in with the green. Like I didn't put anything on it because I do always set my eyes with a powder. So I don't really need a transition shade sometimes when I'm doing these type of colors. So of course I went in with the Urban Decay Electric Palette and I used the shades. This shade is called Thrash. Yeah. I used Thrash in the crease and then I used Freak to darken up the crease more. And then for the lid, I used a ColourPop Super Shock Shadow in the shade Dare. And then I went over it with the Urban Decay After Dark palette and I used the shade Druggy. And then for my outer corners, I used one of the Electric palette shades and I used the shade Urban. And then for the brow bone, I used one of the single eyeshadows from ColourPop in the shade Hear Me Out. Then I lined my eyes with the Stila Sail Day Eyeliner in the shade Black, and then I went in with the Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara on the top. Then I concealed under my eyes with the Urban Decay Concealer, and then I set that with the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder. Then I lined my waterline with the ColourPop Gel Liner in the shade Piggy Bank, and then I highlighted the inner corners with Makeup Geek's Foiled Shadow in the shade Fantasy. And then I went in with the MAC Assembly Giga Black Lash on the bottom lashes. I just wanted it to be another Urban Decay day, so I used a lot of their eyeshadows today, just because I love Urban Decay lately. Then I went in with the Marc Jacobs Instamark Dreamer Filter to contour just slightly. I didn't want it to be too harsh since the eyes and the lips were very bold. I wanted to keep the face pretty simple. And then I actually totally forgot to bake it this morning because I just didn't have time. And then I went in with the, originally I went in with the Clinique Cheek Pop in the shade Pansy Pop, but I just feel like it wasn't pigmented enough. So I just decided to go over it with Benefit's Box Blush in the shade Havana because I just felt like it wasn't really coming off that much. And then I highlighted with the Anastasia Moonchild Glow Kit and I used the shades Lucky Clover and Purple Horseshoe, which I feel like were so cliche and kind of a no-brainer to use for St. Patrick's Day, so. And then I went over everything with the Hourglass Ethereal Light Powder. Then I started doing the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. Then I filled in my brows with the Anastasia Brow Definer in Caramel, and then set that with the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. And then for my lips, I primed them with the NYX Lip Primer, and then I lined them with the ColourPop Lippy Pencil in the shade Lumiere. And then I went in with the Pretty Involved lip again, because I did the same combo that I did when I wore my Evil Queen shirt. I mean, dress the last time. I used Lime Crime's Raven first, Velveteen and Raven, and then I topped it with the Lime Crime Velveteen in the shade Faded because I felt like Faded by itself wasn't the right color. I really need to get a purple that is like this shade. I feel like that this is pretty much what Lumiere looks like Lumiere 2. But I do prefer the formula of the Lime Crime Velveteens over that one. That's why I wanted to wear the Lime Crime Velveteens instead. But yeah, that's it. I'm gonna go. I'm thinking about filming my Hot Topic Disney clothing collection today because I kind of don't want to take my makeup off yet and I kind of want to film something. Because I didn't film yesterday, but I did film the day before. So I'm thinking about doing that now. So yeah, bye!